Blackstone Audio presents The Erotica Book Club for Nice Ladies by Connie Spittler. This book is read by Tanya Eby. Prologue, 1500 AD. The wrinkled hand of Duchess Jardin trembled as she dipped her quill in the pot of blood-red ink. Foxglove, monk's hood, belladonna. She scrolled each scarlet letter with care, spelling out herbal names that dripped with poison, dangerous herbs used by Z, the gypsy healer, in his experimental treatments. Her goose feather pen marked down each remedy, listing the exact ingredients and instructions. She straightened her gold brocade sleeves, then stared out the window of the high tower, thinking back to the arrival of the quiet traveler. He'd requested permission to enter the iron gate of their Alsatian chateau, then told her of his experimental cures. As head of the estate, she'd offered him the storage cave for his work. After a few days, she began to pluck herbs from the bouquets drying in the scullery for him to use in his recipes. Then she began to assist him, crushing and pounding mixtures in the hope of healing her own aches and pains. When signs appeared from others that his curatives had healing powers, she tried small sips, but found no relief from illnesses that ravaged her worn body. Sparrow's song outside the window brought her back to the writing. She began again, this time listing the five ingredients for Z's strange tea. A brew flowery with the fragrance of erotic scents. Dragoncello, mint, lovage, yarrow, lively. It was his only recipe using herbs safe to ingest. When Z declared this brew not only reversed the signs of aging, but increased the appetite for love, she noticed those who drank it regularly appeared younger and more vital. Unable to contain her curiosity, one day she tried the elixir. Reeling from its effects, she crept off to bed to dream of bronzed men who satisfied her in every way. The next day, she walked for hours in the garden, recalling the pleasures that had overtaken her aging body and mind. Returning to the chateau, she worried about ways the tea might affect the lives of castle estate dwellers. When death took some extremely ill patients who'd taken Z's cures, she sent the healer away. But for the Duchess, the question remained. Had the sick and old died as nature intended, or from the healer's potions? Like the gypsy, she believed that Earth's green things could heal. Now, sensing she had little time left to live, she recorded his herbal cures for the future, a time when the validity and safety of such plants could be studied and applied to dreaded diseases of all kinds. After the Duchess finished writing, she folded the pages of cures and placed them in the placket she'd attached to the endpapers of her book of gardening and herbal cures. She lit the candle and applied two red seals, one for the inside pocket that held Z's remedies, the other to seal the cover of her book. The Duchess gathered her strength and wrote a short note to her son. "My beloved Gosbert, you have shown great promise since your father died. My time to pass is near, and now you must guide the workings of our beloved Jardin estate. I ask one thing of you, to lock my book of herbal cures safely away from curious eyes. It contains no personal family secrets, just my drawings and listings of our garden plants and peasant cures. But it also includes the gypsy healer's potions for dropsy, growths, and romantic itching. Keep the book safe in the storage cave until an appropriate time. There is no way to foresee if one day my record of curatives might be thought valuable by truly learned persons and used for serious illnesses that befall others. Your loving mother, the Duchess Jardin." She placed her note on the scarlet cover of the Book of Cures and tied a golden ribbon around it. Weak and weary, she blew out the candle and let her hand rest on a sprig of lovage picked from her garden. She waited for the shadow of death to visit, its lingering weight pressing down on her body. When a breeze sailed by, the frail...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.